Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So in this video, I thought we'll sit down and play with makeup because it's been a while and I have a lot of products which my sister sent, or basically I asked her to send recently a few Instagram famous or TikTok famous products, and I have a few PR products which I want to try as well. So I thought we'll sit down, play with makeup because I feel like that's what I do the best as well, and I feel like you guys enjoy watching it too. So yeah, let's get started. I'm not finding my hair clip, so we will have to do without that today. I do have a lot of products. You want to see what all I'm going to use beforehand, then go check out the reel that I posted. Just making sure I hydrate my face before I go in and apply makeup. Okay, so first product I have is the Ilia Skin Tint. Now, this is an SPF 40 skin tint. My sister said it's like really nice. It gives you a beautiful finish. And it has zinc oxide as its, main sunscreen filter. So that's why I was more excited about it. You saw my sunscreen video. You know that I'm more into mineral sunscreen. So this one has mineral only. And that's why I'm excited to try this. I do have another foundation. This is the Giorgio Armani Silk Luminous Foundation. Now I will do a separate video for this if you're interested, but because in this one I want to use this one, I'm just hoping the shade I picked will match me. And the shade I have is ST 11.5 Morget. So I'm just going to shake it properly. It's like a serum. Just want to use my finger only. It's definitely, I think, way light on me, but I feel like once we blend it out, it might be manageable. It's definitely thick. It's not very thin consistency. It gives me that, you know, tinted sunscreen kind of feeling. I should have gone like a shade darker, especially because I've gotten so tan since Thailand and all my foundations don't match me. Now I'm worried that this also won't match, and these are so expensive, they don't match. It's just like a waste of money. Okay, it's definitely light, but I think I can make it work for now, and I can probably use this in, you know, rainy or winter when I'm a little lighter in shade. But for now I can make it work. It is giving me definitely like good coverage, but it's not a natural finish for sure. It's like a little thicker on my skin, but it's giving me like a lot of glow, but it's like a greasy glow, not like a very healthy glow. And again, I have a lot of texture on my face, so I don't like a lot of like luminous or like dewy, extremely, like there's a good dewy and there's like a bad shiny greasy dewy, which I feel like is not there. I'm yet to set this, but for now it's okay. Like, I am a bigger fan of the Smashbox skin tint, but again, that SPF is very different in that. So with zinc and this finish, I feel like I am quite impressed. Like, if I do the rest of the face, I feel like I will like it. So next I'm going to go in with concealer. Now I don't have any new concealer, so I'm going to go in with Too Faced Born This Way. I also feel like I took way too much of the skin tint. I should have like taken a little bit and tried and see how much coverage it would have given me. I look like a clown right now, I know, because of all that oil and grease which is coming through. But we are going to set it, guys. We will set it in a minute. Next, for blush, I have the Patrick Ta She's the Moment Double Take Creme and Powder blush. Now basically you have cream on one side and then you have powder on one side. How to open this? Oh my god, so fancy. Look at that little flap on the cream so that it doesn't dry out. But I have the shade She's the Moment. It's a very peachy shade. It's something I generally go for, so that's the reason I picked that shade. I don't know why my accent kicks in between for no reason. But that's how it is, guys. Just please bear with me. I can't find my blush brush, so I just have to sit here and just look at it. First, I'm going in with the cream. Now, his technique is to go with powder and cream, but I generally do with cream and then powder only. And I feel like that's what gives me the best finish for my skin. So, okay. Yeah. Now I know I feel like why he would do cream first and then powder, because I don't know if it is the skin tint or the blush. I feel like I have to use this blush with something I generally go for, like a foundation I already have or the concealer I know will already work, because I feel like it is a little tiniest bit on a waxy side, and I feel again that could be the sunscreen, that skin tint as well, because that is leaving me like a cheek filter or a film. So I'm not really sure if it's the blush or the skin tint, but I love the color. I love how it's blending out. It's like super creamy and pretty, and yeah, all nice things. I just want to know how the finish would be otherwise. Okay, next for powder. Oh my god, this one I'm so excited for, because I've heard so much about. So this is the Givenchy, the 4-color setting powder. Okay, so this powder, it comes in 4 different shades. I'm not sure if you can see it. So it has like white, yellow, peach, and a more pinky tone. So it's great to like correct any darkness or pigmentation you have. Like Huda Beauty did like an entire campaign for their peach collection. Like especially if you have like deep set dark eyes and like you like something which corrects darkness. So I feel like this is that, and it comes in 4 different shades. So I'm just going to take, like, I don't think you can individually pick shade, which is a little bit of bummer, because once you do this, all the 4 colors are going to come out. A lot of pink powder has come out, and I've never used actually pink on my skin, so let's see how it looks. Not bad. I mean, it's great, but just to show the difference, I'm going to use my Huda Beauty on the right side. This is the banana powder. I definitely can see the difference. This is more yellow and warm, while this is more pink. Like right now, like with side by side, I can actually see the difference. And I don't know which I like better. Both look really nice though. Huda Beauty is one of really good powders as well. But Givenchy is giving me like nice matte finish, very lightweight, nothing heavy, nothing cakey. It's not creasing. So it's pretty good. Okay, so once I set that skin tint, I feel like it's actually pretty nice. It's the greasiness of that thing was what was bothering me, but this powder and then that skin tint, I feel like now is giving me a pretty good finish. Next time I feel like I have to use a little less of it, and maybe like go a shade darker, and also see if the lesser quantity gives me lesser greasy finish. I will update on that on stories or something, if you want to know if I like it or not. I'll try to use it tomorrow again and see. But again, it's not like a foundation. I can definitely see a little bit of pigmentation coming through around this area. There's been blemishes peeping through. So it is definitely a skin tint, but it was pretty thick for me. Okay, next I'm going to go in with the powder part of the blush. On camera, the powder kind of looks a little faded. This is actually quite pigmented. So I'm just going to go ahead and take that on my powder blush and start dabbing. That is pigmented. I love it. I love the shade. I love how it's blending. That's why I actually want, it's so difficult to try all new products at the same time. That's why I make sure my base or powder, something is similar or like what I already know, so that I know it's not that product. Now, I had an issue with the cream, right? But I love the powder. I actually like the concept that cream and powder isn't the same thing, because I always use a combination of both for my makeup all the time, because blush is the one thing which fades away like this. So I like that it has both. I just want to like the theme more, and I feel like I want to try this without the makeup and see. But like so far, I like this concept and I like how it's looking on my skin. I love the shade as well. It's quite pigmented, so be careful when you're applying it. So pretty. I love it. Okay, moving on to eyes. I have a new palette from... Next for eyes, I have this Back to Basics eyeshadow palette from the brand Mars. Now, Mars has been continuously, consistently Mars has consistently...
English is speaking like a rice palette eating? No. Never. Not.
Mars has been consistently impressing me with their products, and they are so damn affordable. So every time I get a package from them, I'm super excited to try what's in them. So this is their Back to Basics eyeshadow palette. This package I actually got a while ago, but I just never got the chance to try them. So it has all the basic, like everyday shades. I feel like if it works, it would be a great palette to have in hand. Although I'm a very like in a pink mode right now with the blush, I should have seen this palette before the colors, because this has a lot of browns. So I'll try to keep it muted, and I want to make it cohesive to the blush. I am going to try my best. I'm going to take this peachy little pinky shade in this corner. I'm going to start adding that in the face. I have tried Mars eyeshadows before, and I actually do like them. So this one, I just want to see how the blendability is, how the shades are. That blended out pretty nice. I like the shade. Okay, not like very pigmented, but I want to see if they are blendable. I actually like shadows if they're like not in the face pigmented, because once it's on, I feel like I can't blend it out and make it work, because they're too pigmented, and then they don't even get blended out properly. So 50-50 or like 70-30, I feel like I was fine. These are getting blended easily though. You can see that there's a little bit of shade, and that shade is pretty light as well, but it is a little cohesive to my blush. So I just wanted to drape my crease with it. Next, I'm going to take a tinier brush, and I'm going to use a... What do I use? Maybe brown? I'll do like a mix of both. Yeah, see, definitely very like buildable shadows. It's not a one stamp and then you're like, boom, kind of thing. I feel like, which is great for beginners, so that even if they mess up and add a lot, it won't be too much and they can still like blend the product out. But if you're somebody who likes like really pigmented eyeshadows, then you can go for it, because these do take time to get blended. The brown is a little see, but nothing will not work if you blend it. Like everything is going to work. I feel like I just lost my words. Yeah, so for an everyday, I don't mind. But if I want to do like a dramatic look and a more intense look, then I don't think this is going to cut it. Next, if this is going to work for my favorite part, which is the inner corner highlight, then I'll give this palette like a grace, and I'll give it like 9 on 10. I mean, it's not bad, but let me show you like the finish I get with one of my favorite ones. There's no comparison, because the price point is like... Zameen Aasman Farak. But these two shades, which I love using from the Teddy Bear eyeshadow palette, with some face, let's just look at it. Look at that. Just softens everything so well and gives me a beautiful inner corner, like right. Like, look at that difference, bro. I want to see if I can build this up, but so far it's not looking that good. Okay, buildable for sure, but it's too white. Okay, I take my word back. It's quite nice. It's buildable. Like I told you, see these shadows? Buildable is the word. I'm not mad. I like it now. It's not as like evident and smooth as this, but it's still giving me shadow and giving me like light reflection, everything that I want. So I like it. Next, we have a setting spray. Again, I heard Next, we have a setting spray. I've again heard so much about this one that it just like makes everything waterproof. I saw Patrick Starr go into a swimming pool like with this and then nothing moving. So I do want to try it, but I did look at the ingredient list and the initial ingredient is alcohol. So that's why it's going to stay put, which is, I'm sure this is just going to smell like hairspray. Oh yeah. But if it's going to make my makeup last all day in summer, especially maybe on like occasions where you need long lasting on weddings and etc, you can try it, but not every day because alcohol is not good for your face as well. When you try to avoid it in skincare, it's better you try to avoid it in makeup as well. I would rather have you buy the Charlotte Tilbury one, which I actually just bought, which I'm actually using as my mic stand, but that gives you a beautiful finish. This one literally didn't do anything to my makeup. I like my setting spray to kind of melt all my makeup together, which I feel like this one really did not do, and I don't think I can take that smell. Let me just show you how the Charlotte one works, or even leave Charlotte one, even the NYX one is a great one, although this one also has alcohol in it. I just want that some kind of spray which, you know, it's going to kind of lock everything, also melt everything into place. But I feel like this one is not doing, and especially that smell I can't bear. This one also has alcohol, but this at least has a bearable smell. That one is literally like hairspray, like straight up hairspray. Okay, I was just doing my mascara, and I feel like everybody should own this mascara because it's my new favorite. Just look at that difference. This is the after and this is the before. This is the Maybelline Sky High mascara. So I have tried this Sky High long ago, which gives great length as well. It's a great mascara. These are waterproof, which is amazing too. But I tried the Cosmic one lately, and this one I feel like gives a little bit more volume than the normal Sky High. It is a little clumpy, which you can just brush your lashes with a spoolie, but the length it gives, and just look at how voluminous and long my lashes look. I feel like you need to get, you know, this, your hands on this one if you're going to look for a good affordable mascara. If you want, you know, the links of all this, I will leave it in the description, because few of them, these products are available in India too, right? So I will link products in the description box. But this mascara, oh my God. Next, for highlighter, I have the Fenty Beauty Kilowatt Highlighter in Mean Money. Now this one, I've tried it like when they launched only, and I love this one, absolutely love this one. And I had the tiny one before, and that once fell down, broke, and I still used it for a long time, but then it got expired, so I threw it away. And I asked my sister to send me one more, because lately again, I've been wanting to try one, especially now that Fenty is in India. I was like, I think it's time I get my hands on it, and then it's way cheaper there, so that's the reason I asked her to send it from there. But this is one of the best highlighter. This shade, oh my God, on Indian skin tone, it's so beautiful. It's a champagne perfect shade, I feel, and I love it. I absolutely loved it then, and I really was, you know, having major FOMO now, so I might as well send it. It's a beautiful one. I asked her to send the mini only because even if you're buying the mini, if it's available, because that'll only last you a very long time. You don't really have to buy full size ones, especially if you don't do makeup every day. So I'm going to take this. I just love that shade. It's just so pretty. Oh my God. Little girl in me gets so happy when I wear makeup. But finally, we have a lipstick, and I have again new lipsticks from Mars Cosmetics. I'm going to go in, and there are a lot of different shades, but I think I have to use something which matches my vibe right now. And
2 days later.
Is that this? I think so. This is in the shade 17 Glided. Glided a word. It's a beautiful pink shade, so I thought it's going to match the vibe.
Bonk.
That's more brown than pink. This one. This is the shade Candy Rock. It's again a little darker pink. I'm more into lighter shades. That's why so many of these lipstick shades I'm just not into. All the lipstick formulas I really like. Most of the ones, again, I know that they cater to most of the Indian skin tones, but there are people like me who would like to like use like a darker liner and a lighter lip as well, which is rarely available in our market. So again, we have to go for these other brands. Even this one is so damn dark. I don't like it. Shade like, if you prefer a shade like this, then sure, but it's just not my taste. The lipstick is very pigmented and lightweight though. I need to give that to it. It's just the shades which are not my thing. Okay, I actually have new lipsticks from this brand called Stars Beauty as well. They have this jewel lipstick which I really like. I actually reviewed it. So I have a new lipstick which is called Lips Don't Lie Matte Plus Transproof Liquid Lipstick in the shade Nude Spice. I love how this shade is looking. So let's go. See, this is the nude that I'm talking about. Like, look how pretty that is. I know for sure, I know that a lot of people would not prefer such a light shade. You want something bright, which kind of like just brightens up your entire face. But for me, I like something which is really light, and I just like to overline my lip using a lip liner, which I am not able to find right now.
2 hours later.
Okay, that lipstick dried down way too quickly. It's pretty lightweight. It's not extremely drying. It's not causing any like cracks or breaks in my lipstick. So far, I like it, and I really do like the shade. I feel like I messed it up a little bit with the liner, but I'm going to go in with a gloss, and there's nothing a good gloss can't fix. So now you would ask, why go in with a matte liquid lipstick if you are anyways going to apply gloss? The thing is, I want it to be long lasting as well. Now, I really don't mind reapplying my lipstick if it's gone. And I still prefer more like creamy lipsticks than this dry or matte lipstick, because I just feel like they look a lot more prettier and natural. But this one is looking good. So yeah guys, this is the finished look. I actually really like how my makeup is looking now in the end. Initially I was a little skeptical, but I love it. I love how my face is looking. I like my eyes as well. I love my lips. I think everything just came together in the end, and everything is looking really pretty and nice. So I think I'm impressed with all of them. This one I will try once more and let you in the stories if you are interested to see a different way to use it. And I'm sure I will have to set it with powder every time I use it, because it is a little greasy and I do have oily skin. So it would not really work out well if I don't set it. So yeah guys, that's about it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed watching me just sit and play with makeup. I feel like I miss doing these videos. Let me know what reviews you want to see more. I do want to test out more makeup products for you guys. Let me know if you want to see a full-fledged review of this foundation with like wear test and everything. I would love to do that for you. I'm super excited to try this one. I'm just hoping it matches me. Like, by the bottle, I feel like it would, but you know, you never know. So yeah, that's about it. Check out the links if you want to shop any of them, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.